Heyo everybody, Haku here with the next part of our Boku no Hero Acdemia read-through, where I am doing a live reaction and sort of giving my thoughts as we read through it, because I have never read before, of course. So this series is really good so far. I really like the way it was stepping up. It's not really one of my favorites yet, but then again, I've only read 5 chapters, and it's sure to get there, because I have heard so many good things, and I am really, really hoping to enjoy this as it goes along. Also, for what I plan to cover this video, I'm going to try to get through chapter 6, 7, 7.5, 8, and 9, and I'm not sure what 7.5 is. It's probably just sort of one of the little couple-page side omake things, so that'll be pretty cool to add into. So 6, 7, 8, and 9, this chapter hopefully, plus the 7.5 in there as well, while we're going through it. Just because it's there, you know, while I'm reading. I just got done. So, sorry if I had to drink a lot of water or something for this one. I just got done recording my live reaction and review to 12 Beast, and it's chapter 16. And if you guys have not read 12 Beast, the first chapter or two, you might not think it'll be good, or you might not be that into it, but you need to read it. It is... this chapter, chapter 16, pushed it into, like, my list of favorite manga. It's so good, guys. So, I would say definitely check out 12 Beast if you want, and if you like action-adventure shonen, because it's an action-adventure, got a bit of fan service, but, I mean, what doesn't these days? As a little bit more than a little bit of fan service, but still. So, given that recommendation, I did a read-through of it, too, so you can watch my videos on it if you want as well while you're reading through it. But either way, that is way off-topic. Let's get into actually reading this at chapter 6. Chapter 6 is What I Can Do For Now. And also, before I started reading this, somebody in the comments was like, you know, the most important question you have to answer is, who is best girl? And hopefully we'll be introduced to more girls so I can decide. Right now, best girl kind of has to be Urataka, because she is the only one I know. Other than we kind of saw Mount Lady for a second and Izuku's mom. either way. So let's do it. Number 6, What I Can Do For Now. UA file 10 or UA file 1, class number 1B, class number 18. Okay. I don't know what that means, but I'm pretty sure I've heard he's in class 1A, and I guess that means he's seat number 18. Izuku Midoriya, quirk borrowed, one for all. The accumulated and stockpiled strength of countless men crystallized in its user. In the twinkling of an eye, our boy Midoriya can summon an absolutely stupid amount of power. However, the toll it takes on his body when he unleashes his strength at the full 100% is enough to break his bones. So his next challenge is learning to modulate it. Go get him, kid. And it's sort of like the secrets page that Okuyado does for Monmusu. Midoriya's eyes, his tear glands give... his sweat glands a run for their money. Midoriya's hair, curly to the root. Midoriya's sweat, always in overdrive. Midoriya's tie, he's not very good at tying it. Midoriya's whole body, he's training every day to be like All Might. Midoriya's backpack, yellow, outside. Midoriya's shoes, red, outsize. Red, outsize, and fun to draw. Okay, so that's cool. The kid who ranks last gets expelled. They're saying expulsion on their first day. This is our first day here, but even if it weren't, that's just too unreasonable. And I think it's Urataka talking. Yo, and look at his class. I like this dude in the background. His head looks like a rock or something, and he has a squiggly mouth. And this one dude, like, half his hair is white, half of it's black. Yo, and we see the glasses guy from last time. Some dude whose face looks like a bird. Natural disasters, massive accidents, ego-mad villains, all kinds of calamities can happen when we least expect them. Japan's now positively drenched and unreasonable, and it's our job as heroes to reverse it all and restore reason, says the teacher. If you were counting on a friendly chat at the local McDonald's after school, that's too bad. From now on, the next 3 years, all you can expect from your life at UA is one hardship after the next. Yo... this is Plus Ultra. I expect you to overcome these trials and climb to the top. The pressure is on. So this is UA's baptism, the pinnacle of hero training. no choice but to give my all, thinks the glasses dude. I could throw it farther, is thinking Katsuki, or Bakugo. Now then, that was the demonstration, and we see this one chick looking on, look at her face. And I think that's the dick laser dude from the first read through, or at least I think it's a dude, it might be a chick, I can't even tell. Then some other guy, some person with horns, and hello you, some pretty nice looking chick. Okay, time to step up to the plate. And then we see Izuku. Trial 1, the 50 meter dash. Yo, and we see the girl from earlier like running on all fours, tongue hanging out her mouth. 3.4 seconds. Yo, was I right about this dude being a speedster, the glasses dude? Ida Tenya's quirk, engine. It's exactly what it sounds like. Look at those legs. So his legs are like engines? That's kind of weird. Like, I love too how some of the quirks are like what it looks like Udodaka's is, where it looks like she controls gravity or something. Some are like powers like that, and some are legit just like birth defects, like the dude we saw in Izuku's middle school with like the giant cheeks, or the dude with the giant hands. So like some are like superpowers, some are just inconveniences. For the 50 meter, I had to shift straight to third gear, thinks Ida, or Tenya, I don't know which I'll end up calling him. Well, that's him in his element, thinks Eraserhead, the teacher. It's what he'll do for the other trials that interest me. Asui Suyu, time 5.58 seconds. Ribbit. Oh, ribbit, so she's a frog. I like this chick. I'll make my shoes weigh less, and my clothes too, says Uraraka, touching her clothes and shoes. That's interesting. 7.1 seconds. Uraraka Ochiko's quirk, zero gravity. Wow, I managed to shave some time off my middle school record. Middle school was 7.26, and now she's at 7.15. Her ability can reduce the gravitational pull of whatever she touches to zero. However, if she overdoes it, she gets violently woozy. Oh my god, we see Dick Laser, dude. Ha ha ha, everyone's being so artless about it. Get ready. Yoni's jumping up and down backwards. You should use your quirk. Start like this. The dude uses Dick Laser as like a jet engine to propel him backwards. This dude may just be my favorite character. And oh my gosh, it looks like he falls on his back, gets back up on his feet, and launches himself forward with the laser again. 5.51 seconds. If I keep shooting for longer than 1 second, my tum-tum will collapse, you know? What is this guy? A Jama Yuga's quirk, naval laser. This is naval. Middle school was 8.25, and now he's at 5.51. He can shoot lasers from his navel. Its duration is a bottleneck issue, though. Oh, I can't stop laughing at this dude's laser. The pushing of quirks to their utmost limits shows me how much room for growth each of them has and allows me to take note of what they can and can't do just yet, the teacher's thinking. Let's see how you runts use your creativity to keep yourself afloat. Then we see Bakugo and Izuku. Blast rush, he yells. Huh? Runners number 17 and 18. Turbo! Yo, when he launches himself forward, and it looks like he knocks Izuku to the side. Duh! 4.13 seconds. Bakugo Katsuki's quirk, explosion. Just as I thought, if I use both hands, it disperses the power. Middle school was 5.58, now he's at 4.13. What about Deku? Good effort. 7.2 seconds. He went from 7.49 to 7.2. That's still faster than some of the other ones, though. I've got 7 of these left to go. What's more, everyone else will definitely keep using their quirks to net abnormal showings. Meanwhile, my quirk will send me to the hospital after 1 use. Adjustment. I need to adjust it. If I can just visualize it, I'm sure you can do it, Izuku's thinking. And the trick to adjusting is the sensation of... a flashback to All Might. The sensation of it. Just as expected of All Might. So cool, he says. You've already shown us you're 100%. Yeah, and it grounds my bones to dust, says Izuku. Don't you see, kid? Your memory of that sensation is the key. How'd it feel? Well, there was kind of a zap. And then there was like a boom. Imagine like an egg in a microwave. Ding. A bit low-key, kid, but definitely unique, ha ha ha, says All Might with the blood flying out of his mouth. If that's the metaphor you're using, let's lower the wattage and set the timer shorter. However you visualize it, it's fine. As long as the egg doesn't burst, give it some serious thought. Okay, that's really creative. Your first day of school is 3 weeks away. I want you to earnestly ruminate on the image. It may not yield results in just a day or two, but I have faith you can do it. It's only a matter of time. Trial 2, the grip strength test. Don't let the egg explode, he's thinking to himself. Yo, and he's shuddering, and we hear beeping? Whoa. Middle school he went from, so I guess, does that mean it gets heavier? Middle school it went from 40 kilograms to 56 kilograms now. And he's holding it? Oh, so we had to squeeze it and it would measure his grip strength by that. Okay, now I get it. I was being dumb. I thought he had to hold it there and see how long he could last. 540 kilos, says somebody in the background. What are you, a gorilla? No, you're more of an octopus. And it went from 46 to 540. What a monster. Someone say octopus? Hot. Says some little dude with a lumpy head. Yo, this octopus dude, what the heck? Okay, in the skin between his arms, that kind of grosses me out a little. Not gonna lie. Trial 3, the standing long jump. And of course we see Dick Laser dude again, and the explosion dude again. I want to know more about those three dudes, the little dude with the lumpy head and the octopus dude, and the dude he was talking to. Adjust, thinks Midoriya. Trial 4, sustained sideways jumps. Then it looks like the little lumpy dude is just flopping back and forth. And he's just still thinking to himself about adjusting. Trial 5, the pitch. And then Udonaka throws it and it's just floating in the air. Go, go, go. And then infinity. Everybody, infinity. Holy cow, she got an infinity. Oh my gosh. This isn't looking good, thinks Izuku. I can't work out how to do it with so little time. Everybody else has had at least one trial they excelled at. Now all that's left after this is the endurance run, the toe touch thing, and the upper body exercises. If I'm going to grab a high score, it's now or never. At this rate, I'm going to be dead last. Sorry, was checking my recording real quick, make sure we're still good to go. Midoriya's not doing too well, is he? Says Ida. Of course not, he's a quirkless fucking guppy, says Katsuki. Quirkless? Didn't you see what he did at the entrance exam, says Ida? Ha, here comes, thinks the teacher. Mom, All Might? And he's thinking back, you're mega cool right now. You can become a hero. I will be one, he says, his eyes widening. 46 meters. And he looks just distraught and broken. What? Huh? I tried using it for sure right now. I erased your quirk, says Eraserhead. Yo. So is that his power? It defies reason. How'd somebody like you manage to enter the academy, he says. You erased it. And those goggles. Oh my god. He takes the bandages off and he has goggles around his neck. You must be the hero who can cancel out the quirk of whoever he's looking at. The erasing hero, Eraserhead. Yo, that is it. That is a broken as hell power. Eraser? Who? Never heard of him. And it's the class talking and All Might's looking on. I've just heard the name. He's a really underground hero. He says it obstructs his work, so he hates any and all exposure to the media. If only I could have warned you, Midoriya, my boy, says, All Might to himself. He and I don't get along. From what I observed, you can't rein in your quirk's full power, meaning you can't use it efficiently at all, he says, pointing at Izuku. Did you believe someone would come save you after you crippled yourself again? No, I didn't. I just... whatever hopes you may have nursed of your imminent rescue. Sorry, I had trouble reading that. As you can see, nobody is in a position to come to your aid. And he throws the bandage or whatever around Izuku and pulls him closer. There's a certain insufferable hero who made a name for himself rescuing over 1,000 innocents from a disaster all by himself. You've his brute courage, but all you manage to do is run around like a blockhead who needs saving himself. Face it, your power won't help you to become a hero, Midoriya Izuku. And we see Izuku's face juxtaposed against All Might's. Yo, I really like the teacher, dude. I gave back your quirk. Try the ball pitch a second time. Let's get this over with, he says. Are you worried for him? I, for one, don't care. says the Dick Laser dude, putting his hand on Uraraka's shoulder. Who are you? Looks like he's had some coaching before, but, says Ida. He's gonna get expelled for sure, says Katsuki. He's persistent. He's not backing down from dying out here. Or will he simply wither and settle for last place? Thinks Eraserhead as he's putting eye drops in his eyes. Whichever way he goes, he doesn't have a prayer. I still can't adjust my power output, he's muttering to himself. Can I stake my chances at adjusting it on this one pitch? No, it's as All Might told me. I can't get it down in such a short span of time. Shit. Ugh. Well, if that's the case, then nothing for it. Full power. Probability, says Eraserhead. And then, is that... Yo. And then he goes to throw it. Not yet. Zero, says Eraserhead. Aizawa-sensei isn't wrong. If I keep going at it, and like I have been up until now, there's no way I'll ever be a hero. Not yet, he says. Not yet. Whoa, kid. Are you for real? Thinks All Might. If I don't work 12 times harder than everybody else, I'll never make it. At the very last instant, for the very shortest duration, and he has his finger on the end of the ball, I'll go full power now. And then he launches it. I'll show you what I can do. Smash! Yo. And then we hear the beeping on Aizawa's monitor. It's not as excruciating as that other time. And we can see his finger is broken. Yo. He didn't just pitch at full power. He concentrated his power into the tip of his finger. I think I'll start calling him Aizawa. That's his name, right? He didn't surrender, and he didn't march toward failure. He chose a third path. Did you believe someone would come save you after you crippled yourself again? Sensei, he says, I can still move. Yo, and then Aizawa smiles. Aho! And we end it. Yo, that was awesome. I freaking love Aizawa, and I love freaking Izuku as well. And the Dick Laser dude. Dick Laser dude has me pretty weak. So, now we're at Chapter 7. Chapter 7 is called Shall We Wear These? Okay, and this one looks to be 20 pages long. All right, let's get into it. Either way, it doesn't matter. I'm shooting for 6 through 9 either way. No matter how long it takes or how short it takes, I'm going to try to get through it. I was worried there for a second, but that was superb, my boy. It looks like All Might is thinking. A hero in the making. He still can't adjust the power output, yet he also can't afford to cripple himself. So he waited until the very last second and focused one for all at the tip of his finger. He used it for the shortest time possible, at the last moment possible. You know what, kid? You're actually pretty cool right now. And it's back to him saying, I can still move. You finally got a record suitable for a hero. Yay! is Uraraka yelling. Your finger swollen. Reminds me of the entrance exam incident. What an odd quirk, says Ida. It's not stylish enough, says Dick Laser Dude. And then Katsuki's just looking on in shock. That face panel. What the fuck? A quirk manifests by age 4 at the latest. It's impossible, and yet, he said he'd won it. What is this, Deku? Explain now, shit rag. He says, coming at him with an explosion. Wah! And Izuku starts yelling. And then, his face and body get held back by the bandages. Shit's this cloth. I can't... It's my special capturing weapon. a steel wire alloy woven with carbon nanofibers. Geez, don't make me use my quirk so much. He says, I guess he looked at Bakugo to, stop his, powers. I've got dry eye, damn it. His quirk's amazing, but it seems like a waste on a guy with dry eye. Aizawa Shota, he can erase the quirk of anyone he looks at, but when he blinks, the effect turns off. That's really cool. We're wasting time. Prepare for the next trial. Is your finger all right? Says Uraraka. Yeah. Ch, says, Katsuki walking off. Up until now, you were just another pebble on the road. And he's thinking about their past together. I'm jealous. Your quirk is such a cool one, Kachan. I hope mine comes in soon, too, says Izuku. I told you, no matter what kind of quirk you get, Deku, it'll never measure up to mine. He should have been nothing more than a pebble in my path. I couldn't get any other records of note while battling the pain, and we're back to Izuku's thoughts. Then all 8 trials came to a close. Time to present the results, says Aizawa. If my total's the lowest, I'll get expelled. Did anyone else get such low scores? The only real record I managed to excel at was the ball pitch. The total is simply the aggregate sum of each of your scores. If I recited all your scores, it'd take 1,000,000 years, so I'll just close them all at once, says Aizawa. And then Izuku's thinking, I did miserably at every other trial. I did especially horrible on the endurance run, since I could barely stand the pain. If I'm expelled... Oh yeah, that whole expulsion thing was a lie, says, Aizawa. But again, I assumed it was a lie. And then he smiles. It was a logical ruse to pull out your best performances. His freaking smile is the best. I freaking love Aizawa. And then everyone's shock faces. What? And then especially Izuku's. Izuku's shock face where he's just a blur. Come on, guys. Use your brains, says Smexy potential waifu chick. Of course it was just a ruse. Yo, I like this chick. Oh, sorry. I'm gonna grab some water right quick. And right. Yep. With that, it's over. Says Aizawa walking away. Your curriculum sheets are in the back of the classroom, so give them a once over. And Midoriya, go to recovery, girl, and get yourself patched up, since your eyeballs will doubtless pop out of their sockets at tomorrow's absurd ordeal. Oh my gosh, what was that? Don't get me wrong, I'm glad I'm safe, but there's still too much I can't do. Thinks Izuku. Last place isn't exactly a promising start. Yo, and we see... Okay, we see the people in this class. Midoriya, Izuku, he was in 20th. Anybody else that we know? Toru, Minoru, Kyoka, I don't know any of them. Denki, Sero, Aoyama, don't know any of them. Uraraka's in 10th. Yo, Uraraka's a beast. No, don't know any of these other people. Ida is in 4th. Katsuki's in 3rd. I thought they were going to give him 1st. Who are the top 2? Todoroki Shoto. Who was he? Oh wait, I did recognize one of those names. The Yuga guy, right? No, maybe not. I have no idea. But Yaoyorozu Momo is 1. Okay. From here on, I'll study my ass off so I can reach my dream. Okay. So, hype for some characters? Aizawa, you liar, says All Might walking up to Aizawa. Oh, it's All Might. So, you were watching, I take it? You must be free, then. A logical ruse. April Fool's was 1 week ago. You expelled an entire new class of first graders last year. And the book's title is called Register of Instructors, the book that All Might's reading. So he did expel the entire class last time, so it wasn't a lie. You kick kids out without a moment's hesitation if you judge them as having 0 chances. This is a total 180 from what you used to always say. Could it be because you felt it too, right? Midoriya's raw potentially says, pointing at him. You too, says Aizawa. So you have his back, right? Normally that'd be against your teaching style. His chances are above the 0 mark. That's all, says Aizawa. Yo, I freaking love him. I can kick out anyone whose chances drop below that mark at any time. It's not a cruel thing to end the half-assed chasing of a dream. So that's your brand of kindness, is it, Aizawa? However, just as I thought, we'll never get along. And then all the students are looking at him. Oh my god, it's All Might. End of the first day. School's out. And then he's walking out. I'm pooped. Is your finger healed? Says Ida. I kind of like Ida too at this point. He's kind of grown on me. Ah, oh, hey Ida, yeah, recovery girl saw to that. And then smooch, she kissed his finger to make it better. Wow, amazing, it's really healed. But suddenly, I feel so tired. He'd faint it last time recovery girl healed him, so he doesn't remember. All my quirk does is magnify your own body's regenerative processes. In order to heal, you need to use up some of your strength. If you keep getting injured and use up too much of your body's energy to regenerate, you'll just end up dying anyway, so be careful. I'll die anyway, he says. That'll probably be important in the late game of the story, or in a very serious arc. I can't go on like this, getting rescued all the time. I gotta learn to adjust to it quickly, thinks Izuku. I have to say, says Ida, Aizawa-sensei really got me. I had actually thought, so this is what the highest academia is like. Now I see how a teacher can encourage through deep deception, through deception. Before, I saw Ida as scary, but he's really, but he's just a really honest, diligent guy. Is what he's thinking. Hey there, hey you two, says Uraraka running up to them. You headed towards the station? Wait for me. You're that Infinity Girl. Infinity Girl? He thinks. Hi, I'm Uraraka Ochko. Ida Tenya, and if I'm not mistaken, Midoriya Deku? Deku, he says. Oh my gosh. Eh? Wasn't that what that Bakugo kid called you? Deku, you fuck munch. I love the flashback, Deku, you fuck munch. Or the like. Actually, my name's Izuku. Deku is just what Kachan calls me to demean me. Oh, so it's an insult, says Ida. Eh, for real? Sorry. But you know, I kinda like the name Deku for you. It gives me a sort of never-give-up vibe, you know? Hi, I'm Deku, he says. Midoriya, yells Ida. Oh my gosh, I love that turn. I may not have a lot going for me at the moment, but like she said, I can't give up. So don't be so weak-willed. It's an insult, remember, says Ida. It's like when Copernicus flipped the paradigm. Copernicus, huh? Says, Uraraka. But you know something, All Might? And then, Midoriya. And it's flashbacks of his old class laughing at him. I'm ecstatic just to have gotten far enough to make some real friends. Aw, and it shows Izuku walking out with Ida and Uraraka. Sorry, my boy, but we haven't got any time to relax, says All Might. The real test starts tomorrow. Yo, and then it looks like we're flashing forward to tomorrow. Come join the Kendo Club, people are saying outside of the school. And then we see, what's the dude's name, Present Mike again? Alright, class, tell me where the mistake is in the next English sentence example. Who knows the answer? Everybody, hands up and raise them high. So normal. Everybody's thinking it's so normal, like a normal class. Before noon, we have normal lessons for all the required subjects. And then Katsuki, so fucking boring. And then Izuku's thinking, oh, I know, the past participle is in the wrong place. So number four. And then at noon, we gather at the Grand Mess Hall to sample first-rate cuisine for the cheap. Cooking Hero Lunch Rush. Yo, what is with this dude's face? He ended up settling into the white rice world of school lunches, huh? What the heck is this dude? Cooking Hero Lunch Rush? He's just a cook. Oh my gosh. And then finally, the afternoon portion, our daily foundational heroic studies. It's me, says freaking All Might. You came, says Izuku, through the door like a normal person. I can't believe it. It's All Might. He's really going to be teaching us. That design's so Silver Age. The art style clashes so much it's giving me goosebumps. Foundational Hero Studies, and he's wearing the super suit. For this class, we'll be building up your hero foundation through various trials. You'll get tons of credit for it. Let's jump right in with this. The Trial of Battle, and he holds up a card or something that says Battle. The Trial of Battle? Or the Trial, says Katsuki, so excited. Of Battle, says Izuku, all worried. And to go with your first battle, we've prepared the gear we had you send in requests for to match your perks. Yo, so they get super, getting super suits? Our battle gear, everyone says. Awesome. My costume, says Izuku. Get changed and we'll be ready to go. Everyone gather at ground beta. Yeah. The garb you bring into the battlefield is vitally important, boys and girls. And don't forget, from here on out, you're all officially heroes. Yo, we see everyone's super suits. Yo, Bakugo has the giant grenades for hands. And his suit looks sort of like a grenadier soldier. Udodaka's is looking pretty fire. Some dude in a knight suit. Oh, his legs look like engines. That might be Ida. That looks really cool. See, Frog Girl, the octopus dude, the dude with the dick laser looks like he has armor too, the dude with the lumpy head. Hey, wait for me! And Izuku's running out. What is it? Excelsior, the witness of the debut of these fresh new heroes. Alright, let's see what you're made of, you embryos, says All Might. And that's where this one ends. Yo, the hype. Hype is real. Hype is prepared. Oh, now we have 7.5. Let's see what 7.5 is all about. Okay, let's see how long it is really quick first. 7.5, 17 pages. Alright, let's see what it is. Or I might not read it. It looks like it might actually be... Hold on. It looks like it might actually be the first chapter again in color? Hold on. No? Or maybe not. I'm not sure. It was the cover from the first chapter only in color. And it looks like the first drafts, yeah, for, wow, All Might and Udodaka look way different. Katsuki and, Izuku look about the same, but Izuku's name's different. Okay, that's really interesting. Okay. So far, there has not really been anything. We have, it's like the info thing that they did on, Izuku. Oh, whatever, let's read it. It's him in a civilian clothes. Birthday, June 10th, 220 centimeters. He likes the Cedars of Yakushima and film. Inside store, okay, hold on. Okay, yeah, sorry, I'm not reading all that because it's just the author's notes on the character. Let me see, Midoriya Izuku. Okay, I'm just going to go through it because, I mean, you don't want to hear me just do the author's notes on the characters. Get to see Bakugo, Udodaka. Yo, I like Udodaka. Then Ida, pretty cool, likes beef stew. Yo, Eraserhead, Aizawa Shota. Dude, I love this dude. It seems like his room has nothing in it. Alright, so that's all that was, I guess. Just the little character pages. I ain't reading all of them, though, because they're characters that we already have kind of been introduced to in the story. Okay, looks like it's it. Okay. Yo, Mount Lady, though. Mount Lady all day, guys. Okay, why is this not loading? Come on, next chapter. And now we've got chapter 8, The Ferocity of a Fucking Nerd. Okay. Just checking all my stuff, making sure the recording and everything is still good. Still alright. Okay, let me get a sip of water before we start this next one. Alright, this one's likely to be about the same length as the last one. Okay, for some reason it's loading not very well. The site must be hitting some high traffic. The costume subsidy. Before entering the academy, one is asked to send in a report on their quirk and their body specs. The affiliated company attached to the school then takes that information and makes their ideal costumes. It's a smooth system. Costumes are the symbols of heroics. No ordinary garb will suffice. Detailing specific requests is accepted, and so their state-of-the-art costumes are crafted. And we get to see some of the designs, like for Lumpy Head's costume and for Bakugo's. About 3 weeks ago, I've got to go to City Hall and do the quirk report things for the costume, says Izuku. The problem is, I'm registered as no quirk. What should I do? Oh, your quirk registration? You can update it, says All Might on the phone. Really? You know how they assess and register everyone's quirks during their first year at elementary and middle school? Every once in a while, they'll accept updates to their records. Take the example of a quirk which was originally thought to be something like shooting water from within one's body, but then it was actually discovered to be drawing moisture from the surrounding air. It's like that. As long as the revision isn't too out there, then it'll be accepted. And since you're down as no quirk anyway, it should probably be good. I'm home, says his mom walking in. Probably. Actually, more like deaf. And then Izuku hangs up. I drop the call without thinking. Gotta apologize to him later. Hey, mom, he says, turning around. Izuku, I've got something for you, she says. Let's celebrate your new school life. And she pulls out this jumpsuit. A jumpsuit? It probably won't look very cool, but I caught you having fallen asleep from intense study, and my eye happened to fall on your open notes. Back then, I said something I shouldn't have, and I feel awful. When she was like, Izuku, I'm so sorry. I'm ashamed I gave up on you so easily, yet you kept chasing after your dreams, never giving up. I'm sorry, Izuku. Yo, his mom is so cute. I freaking love her. I think that maybe the weight gain was used to symbolize her grief and, like, her guilt over how she never thought he could do it. And that's why he's drawn the weight gain with her. Like I said a few chapters back, that it was notable enough that the author likely did it for a reason. I think he's doing it to show the guilt. From now on, I promise to cheer you with arms flailing, she says. This costume holds within it mom's heart and feelings, he said. No matter what trouble they find themselves in, he saves everyone with a smile. It's not hyper-efficient or state-of-the-art, but it suits me just fine. You're a mega-cool hero. I'm proud to wear this, he says, walking out. Yo, and the things on it look like All Might's hair, and it has the smile across the front of it, so that he's always smiling, even when he's scared. Yo, this is awesome. As my costume. Let's see what you're made of, embryos. Yo, some of their costumes look kind of like normal clothes. So, I mean, what's the point? It's time for that trial of battle. Hey, Deku, says Uraraka. Cool costume. It looks really practical. Uraraka, whoa, he says. I wish I'd drawn my request sketch a little earlier, she says. My costume came out a bit puffy. It's embarrassing. Heroics is the greatest, says the lumpy-haired dude walking up to Deku. I'm liking everyone's styles. Very cool. A bit transparent, says All Might, and it's showing the spikes on his head and how they look like Izuku's costume. Sensei, regarding the performance ground we'll be using, is it the mock city from the entrance exam? Says Ida. And then Izuku's thinking, ah, so it's Ida in there. He's looking pretty cool in that too. So yeah, Ida's the one in the knight-looking armor, the like full-body armor. You'll see, in fact. Take two steps and you'll be there, says All Might. Sorry, my nose itches. Like the tip of it. This will be an indoor battle trial. Civilian cleanup is usually seen out in the open, but statistically, the better part of it is an indoor job. Most acts of villainy are committed indoors. That's kind of an interesting thing to note. Imprisonment, house arrest, the black market, and this hero-saturated society. Why any villain with intelligence is lurking in the shadows? True. For this test, you'll separate into villain and hero groups for a two-on-two team battle. That's interesting. What about the foundational training, says Frog Girl. This is foundational training. Only this time, there won't be any robots. It'd be okay, there won't be any robots, it'd be okay to just destroy. So how do we determine who wins and who loses, says, Spexy-looking chick. Is it okay if we just blow them away, says Bakugo? Is there a threat of expulsion, like with Aizawa-sensei's exercise, says Uraraka. If we're separating into different groups, what would be the best way to do so, says Ida. Doesn't this cape look killer on me, says Dick Laser Dude. Oh my gosh, sorry, I dropped my mouse. Yo, I freaking love Dick Laser Dude. I can't hear if you all speak at once, says All Might. For this training, we'll have some villains guard a nuclear weapon they intend on deploying, and the heroes must stop them in their nefarious scheme before it's too late. Sounds like Golden Age superhero stuff. Thanks, thanks, Izuku. The heroes capture the villains or reach the nuclear core before the time runs out, they win. If the villains manage to keep the core the whole time or capture the heroes, they win. Your teammates and opponents will be chosen by lottery. Is that really how we'll do it, says Ida? Well, pros are often forced to make impromptu team-ups with other heroes they might not know very well, so this is probably testing that, says Izuku. Anyway, let's start this, says, All Might. I see. Always with our eyes on the future. Always with our eyes on the future, are we? I apologize, says Ida. I freaking love Ida. And then we see Team A is Uradaka and Izuku. Team B, we have some dude with this cracked mask-looking thing, and it looks like the octopus dude's face. Team C, we have Smexy Chick and Lumphead. Team D, we got Katsuki and Ida. Or Team D, I mean. Team E, we have Dick Laser Dude and the chick with the horns, it looks like. I don't know. Are those horns? Are they antennae? Is she like a bug? Team F, we have some dude in like a, what's it? Like a, I can't think of the word. What is the word? Like a luchador type mask and the dude with the rock looking head. G, we have some chick with black hair and some guy with blonde hair. Team H, we have the frog chick and the bird looking dude. Team I, we have some furry looking dude and some floating hands. Maybe it's an invisible person. Team J, we have Daft, somebody that looks like Daft Punk, and some dude in a cool, badass looking mask, actually. This dude looks really badass on Team J. Wow, we must be linked or something. Pleased to have you, says Uradaka. Seriously, say anything, man. Speak words, says Izuku, shaking. And the first two pairs to do combat, says All Might, drawing into a hero and villain pile, will be the following. A and D, of course. Pair A will be heroes, pair D will be villains. Of course. So it's gonna be Katsuki versus Izuku already. This scenario has the villains inside the building first, then after 5 minutes the heroes will be let in as well. Everyone else will be able to watch what unfolds through the surveillance cameras. This will allow young Ida and Bakugo to get inside the heads of the villain kind. This is a practical training exercise, so go all out without fear of injury, though naturally we'll cut it short if things get out of hand. Yo. It may be a training exercise, but it still pains me to be a villain, says Ida, though I suppose I just need to defend this thing. Sudeku's got himself a quirk after all, right? Says, Katsuki. You saw it for yourself, says Ida. Didn't you? That Herculean strength? It looks pretty high risk, but you'll just charge it right at Midoriya anyway, won't you? Were you fooling me all this time, you fucking nerd? Says Katsuki to himself. A layout of the building. Guess we have to commit it to memory, says Uradaka, looking at the map with Izuku. It doesn't seem like there are any penalties like with Aizawa-sensei, so I'm relieved. All Might's as nice a person as his image on TV. You don't look relieved, says she looks at Izuku and he's just shaking. Oh no, sorry, it's just my opponent is Kachan and Ida too. I guess I'm just really tense. I see. I remember now. It was Bakugo who keeps bullying you. I'm gonna surpass even All Might, says flashback to the beginning with Bakugo. Bastard is top hero. Or surpass that, All Might bastard is top hero. I hate his guts, says Izuku, but I also admire him. His ambition, his confidence, his strength, his quirk. He's better than me in 100 different ways. All the same, this time I feel I don't want to lose, if that makes sense. I really like Izuku's costume. So then this must be fate, the bonds between men. Oh man, I'm sorry for blabbing on about something that has nothing to do with you. It does too, we're a team now, aren't we? Let's do our best, says Uradaka. Trial of indoor battle, start. That same building's basement monitors. Now watch and hatch strategies of your own, says So yeah, they're at a real disadvantage going first, is All Might talking to the class. Midoriya, my boy, here you are, just another student to me. Don't expect any favoritism. I'll grade you just as harshly as the rest, says, or thinks All Might, pulling out the pen and clipboard. Infiltration, success, says Uraraka as her and Izuku sneak in the window. There are a lot of blind spots, so let's be careful. I still can't adjust one for all, so I can't use it for hand-to-hand. If I used it against someone, it'd straight-up kill them, thinks Izuku. It's my base strength and Uraraka's zero gravity. That's all we have in our arsenal. Make full turns, just like those notes on battle in enclosed spaces. Try to remember them all. Yo. A sudden ambush, says the lumpy-haired dude, and Bakugo jumps out of the hallway at them. Makes an explosion against the wall. Wah, says Uraraka as Izuku tackles her out of the way. He grazed me. You okay, Uraraka? Yeah, thanks. And half of Izuku's mask is burnt off already. He came like a bolt. Damn it, Deku, don't dodge me. I thought so. With me as his opponent, Kachan's priority would definitely be to beat me up. That Bakugo is a cheater. An ambush is so unmanly, says the badass-looking dude. Ambushes are good strategy. They are in the heat of battle, after all, says All Might. Midoriya actually ducked away from it pretty well, says the kind of cute-looking bug or horned chick from before. I'll blow you away, but just short of getting this interrupted, says Katsuki, going at him with his arm. Yo! Izuku freaking grabs his arm. Is he gonna toss this dude? Wow, just like an expert. What the hell did this little shit just read me? Whoa! Wah! And yo, freaking Izuku just slammed Bakugo's ass down. Yeah! Yo, and everybody's looking on through the monitors. Yo guys, quick but sad news. While I was doing this episode of the read-through, the audio was corrupt for the last two pages of this chapter, which is chapter 8, and all of chapter 9. So I'm going to reread it and give my thoughts here, but this is not my first time reading it, so it's not my initial reactions, because pretty much I had so much trouble with this video, and that's why if you're watching it, it was up late. It was supposed to be up last weekend, but basically, that audio was corrupt, so I tried to re-record it like this once, and my computer crashed while I was re-recording it, which was freaking terrible. I lost all my progress and stuff with what I had been doing in editing, too, because I had still had the editing stuff up, so it destroyed me. And now I'm re-recording it, trying once again. Hopefully the audio won't be corrupt. The audio is just a little staticky, but it's not really bad for the outro. In the outro, I was giving my general first thoughts a little bit on some of the stuff we had read. So I'm going to keep that in. I'm going to keep the outro the same. And right here is just the only thing I'm re-recording is going to be my reading of the last two pages and thoughts of the last two pages of Chapter 8 and my reading and thoughts of 9. So yeah, this shouldn't happen again because I'm actually ordering a new microphone today. And hopefully that'll fix the problem and we won't have to deal with any audio issues ever again, because I'm pretty certain it's my microphone's fault. It's just, I bought it in February and it's getting a little bit old, I guess. It's pretty cheap, but I'm getting a new one this week, so hopefully not a problem again. Okay, so we had just gotten to the part where Izuku had slammed down Katsuki. So, Kachan, you always lead with a big right swing. I can't count how many times I've seen you do it. I analyzed and took notes on all the heroes I thought were amazing, including you. The same notes you blew up and tossed away. And we see the flashback of Katsuki throwing his notebook out the window. I'm no longer the Deku you equated with a worthless scuppy. Now I'm... Okay, next page. The Deku whose vibe is never giving up. And we see his flashback to Uraraka telling him about liking Deku because it gives him the vibe of never giving up. You used to piss your pants before me. I see how it is now. And then we see Ida. Damn you, Bakugo. He just flew out of sight. What's up with that guy? Seriously. Now I'm really pissed. Next issue, a clash. Or, this clash will get a center colors page. Okay, so before I get into reading chapter 9, some real quick thoughts. Katsuki seems like the character I'd like. The big, loud, cussing guy who doesn't play by the rules. It seems like the kind of character I'd like, but I just feel like, at least for right now, at least for this moment, he feels like he's fallen into that angsty childhood friend there to just be angsty and be a bad guy. He's fallen into the Sasuke area. So, I don't think he's a terrible character, but I think that, that's not very good at the moment. And right now I think Ida might be my favorite character. I think Ida is hilarious. I wasn't expecting to like him very much, but Ida's pretty funny. I really enjoy him. Okay, the time has come for their fated clash. And we see the, colored cover page, and then we get a flashback. Our houses were in the same neighborhood, so Kachan and I were childhood friends. Kachan was the boy commander, the invincible rogue who could do anything if he just did it. Putting aside right and wrong, I was simply impressed with how full of confidence he was, and admired him from the rear. Okay, and I laughed the first two times where I was like, they could have worded that better. But we see them as kids with Katsuki leading all of the boys on a little pretend adventure. But after his quirk manifested, it all took a turn for the worst. I know that people aren't equal from birth. I knew even when I was 4, the truth everyone in society knows. And then we go back to the current time. Now I'm really pissed. Hey Bakugo, tell me what's going on, what's happening, says Ida through the radio. Shut up and keep guarding. I'm really fucking pissed right now. When did I ask how you were feeling? Hey, he hung up on me. Why that little... I freaking love Ida so much. Okay, just checking, making sure my recording's good right now. Yep. And then we have the cool look... This dude looks so badass with the mask. I want to know more about this dude. He looks awesome. What is he saying? There's no sound through the surveillance footage. Then we get All Might explaining the game. Teammates can communicate through wireless transceivers, and they all have a rough sketch of the building. And then, there's this capture tape. The second someone's wrapped this around their opponent, that's a sign that they're captured. The time limit is 15 minutes, and the heroes don't know exactly where the core is being held, right? And then we have this... The girl that... I think she's really cute looking, with the horns and the puffy hair, or at least I think they're horns. The hero side is at a pretty heavy disadvantage in this scenario. The guy behind her looks kinda cool too, though. Didn't Aizawa teach you kids our motto? Says All Might. Say it with me now. Plus Ultra! And him and a bunch of them are yelling. Then we see a dick laser dude. Ah, Monsieur Bakugo. And we see Bakugo flying towards Izuku using his explosions as a shockwave to propel him forward. Uraraka, go on without... Gah! And then he blocks a kick to the side of his head from Bakugo. And Uraraka's running off. You don't have any margin to look away, says Katsuki. Yo, and then Izuku wraps the capture tape around his leg. Proof of capture. Notebook number 10, page 18. I can visualize it. What he'll do next. If I know Kachan, he'll start getting hasty. Shit. And here comes the big right swing. And Izuku ducks under it. Yo, I really like Izuku. He's a really good main character. Look at him go. He still hasn't used his quirk once, but he's still going toe-to-toe, says the, it looks like the, luchador-looking guy, with the kid who got first place in the entrance exam. He's impressively quick on his feet, and then we see All Might thinking. The boy has jotted down these for who knows how many years. His head must be swimming with tons of accumulated otaku knowledge, or hero otaku knowledge. I got him. And then we see Izuku thinking, and the flashback in his head to when All Might told him he could become a hero. He pushed my back against the wall, but that being said, the rest won't be so easy. I feel vindicated. I need to come up with a plan, and he ducks around a corner. Get back here, Deku, yells Katsuki. Yo, where are you? You tricked me, didn't you? Were you having a laugh all this time? Well, your quirk is actually pretty damn flashy, ain't it? Why don't you use it, since mine is even stronger? Damn, that kid's pissed, says one of the dudes. It's scary. And then All Might's thinking, young Bakugo has heard the pourings of young Midoriya's heart, and yet he's still full of confidence. His head is bloated beyond all reason. I see. And then back to Midoriya. As expected, he's totally disregarding Udadaka and focusing on me. Any decent strategy on their part would have sent Ida as the vanguard, if at all. He would have had the speed advantage in that state of affairs, and he must know that. This is no predetermined strategy the two of them cooked up. This is Kachan's blind rage, pure and simple, which means our opponents aren't in accordance at the moment. And yeah, this too made me think, Kachan's a bitch. Katsuki's a bitch, because I mean, like, if they wanted to win, like, Ida would, he's fast, he could run through those hallways and take him out early, or Katsuki would be pretty much, with his explosions, would be pretty much unbeatable, like, guarding something, so they would have had them beat, or if they went 2-on-2, just waited at the objective, they would have had him beat, because their quirks just match up kind of well. All they have is Udadaka's gravity, and then Izuku can't use anything without hurting himself. So they could, this is something that they should, in all reasonability, win, but they may be losing just because Katsuki isn't bright enough and is too arrogant and just runs in. If they'd stuck together, attacked us head-on from the start as a united front, thinks Izuku, then our chances of winning would have been the slimmest. If I'd gone with Udadaka, it'd become that worst-case scenario. And if we both fought Kachan here, then we'd likely run out of time. This is the best for us. Now it's just down to whether Udadaka can successfully reach the core. This might as well be 2-1. It's ours to win. That's based on the assumption that I'll beat Kachan, of course. But I think I can do it. I just need to pay close attention to his palms. Let me see a flashback. Where does a quirkless loser like you get off putting himself on the same level as me? I'm not trying to compete with you or anything, honest. I forgot to tell you before, Kachan, but I take that back. And then we see Katsuki stomping through the halls. You can't stop me. I'm headed to Yue. Izuku, you really can't do anything, can you? I'm the Deku whose vibe is never giving up. And then we see all the thoughts in his head and we go into a flashback. You can read the letters and Izuku's name is Deku. Wow, Kachan, you can read already, says one of the kids. What, you can't? From now on, a Deku is a person who's totally useless at everything. Stop it, says little Midoriya. That's so? Wow, Kachan, you're so smart. Why don't they know anything? Wow, Kachan, how many times did it skip? 7 times. What about yours, Deku? 0. Why can't he do anything? Whoa, that's a fantastic quirk, the teacher is saying in their little kindergarten. It's flashy enough for a hero's work, Katsuki. Oh, I get it now. I'm just awesome, and everyone else isn't. And we see how he got that way, sort of. Your quirk is so cool, Kachan. I wonder when mine'll come in. Whatever quirk you get, I'm sure it'll never measure up to mine. He's just a pebble. He said he doesn't have a quirk. Eh, it's called quirkless, so lame. Deku is the least amazing of all. And then we see all the kids walking across the log over a river, and Katsuki falls into the river. Kachan fell in. Hey, are you okay? Ah, he'll be all right. He's tough. Don't keep us waiting. I was totally fine. There wasn't a scratch on me. Yeah, it was nothing. And we see Izuku climbing into the river behind him to help him up. Are you okay? Can you get up? If you hit your head, that'd be bad. Don't look at me with that expression. Your eyes were pleading for help. I am above you. And then we see Udadaka looking into the room with the core. Found you. Now, I just need to stay hidden until Deku arrives. Oh my gosh. And then I loved this part so freaking much, where we see Ida sitting there thinking to himself, Bakugo is naturally rotten, but that actually hits the mark for this exercise. Following that train of thought, I ought to act more like a villain as well. Yes, this too is simply another trial to becoming a splendid man worthy of the Ida family name. Put yourself in a villain's shoes. Wreathe thyself in the pitchest black. I am now quite evil. Oh my god, I love that freaking so much. Ida is the best character. And then he's so earnest, Udadaka laughs inside of her mask. And he looks over at her. So you've come, Udadaka. I knew you'd come here alone as soon as Bakugo bolted off. Yours is a quirk that causes whatever you touch to float. With that in mind, I move to counter you by giving this floor a thorough cleaning. He is the funniest freaking character. He cleaned the floors. Now there'll be no little tricks you can try. And then she's like holding in a laugh. It looks spick and span. You've made an error in your calculations, Hero. Ida is the freaking best. To avoid getting read by me again, he led with a kick. He's caught on. I won't be getting under his guard again. Need to think of a plan, says Izuku. Deku, Uraraka says over the radio. Uraraka, what's up? I got discovered by Ida. Sorry. Now he's edging closer. Where are you? I don't want to take my gloves off on her, but... thinks Ida. The middle room on the fifth floor, says Uraraka through the radio. She's almost right above me, thinks Izuku. We don't have that much time left, and if time runs out, it's their win. This is the one place. This is the one place I definitely don't want to lose. It's ready, says, Katsuki. Why won't you use it? Are you looking down on me, Deku? Kachan. No choice. I can do it. I know I can. I'm not afraid of you anymore, he says. I already know about all of your... about all your stalking, you know, says Katsuki. My explosions are sparked by the sweat on my palms, which is like secreting nitroglycerin that detonates. Now, if the specs are as I ask, then I can store that nitro sweat into this bracer, and then he pulls the trigger on the big, like, grenade things on his arms. No, could it be? Bakugo, my boy, stop this. Yo. You'll kill him. If it doesn't hit him, he won't die, says Katsuki, preparing to pull the pin. Yo, and I love how it's, man. And then Bakugo pulls the pin. We see the massive, massive explosion coming at Izuku. Yo. Wah! And then the ground's shaking and Uraraka and Ida react to it. This is meant to be a lesson, says the really badass-looking dude. Midoriya! And then we see Katsuki. Are you out of your mind? And then Katsuki. Use your quirk, Deku. I'm gonna break you at your full strength. Bakugo Katsuki's quirk, Explosion, comes in the form of sweat on his palms. That, similar to nitroglycerin, can be made to detonate. And more he sweats, the more powerful the explosions. And that is the end of chapter 9. Man, I feel so bad ending there. I can't, like, it's such a struggle with doing this week to week, not being able to read ahead. It is such a struggle, guys. But, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And now I'll switch back to the normal outro, because I did have some thoughts there. And, there's probably going to be a tiny bit of static in it, so sorry about that, but, either way, thank you, and thank you for putting up with that. And then this weekend, with the new microphone, hopefully the next segment of this will be up. So, thank you, and I'll see you all later. Thank you for watching. I thought all these chapters were really freaking good. Definitely steps up. I'm really loving this game. And, yeah, I'm really freaking enjoying this. So, anyway, I guess, that's it. So, like if you did like the video. Comment down there. Tell me what you thought of, my thoughts and my reaction to all of these chapters and what you're thinking so far. I am liking a lot of these characters. I freaking love Ida. I like Uraraka. Katsuki's a dick. He's still a pretty cool character, but I don't really like him at this point. I really like Izuku a lot. Really freaking like Aizawa. He's a badass. I like spiky haired chick. The chick with the horns or antennae is pretty cute. Yeah, other than that, I guess that's all I got for basic thoughts on characters. Subscribe for more Boku no Hero Acdemia and all my other stuff like 12 Beasts that I mentioned earlier. Follow on Twitter if you want. I'll try to keep you updated there on stuff. And next weekend, I should have up the next 4 chapters, or maybe even before that. Who knows? Probably not before that. Probably not until next weekend. So, thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you all next time.